Very good morning, all of you. Today, I'm going to start a new topic in the radar and TV engineering, that is the radar applications and the frequencies. So in the previous section, we already discussed the basic things of the radar. What is the radar? What are the construction and the working principle of the radar? So we have already discussed these points in a previous section. We already designed the radar block diagram and already discussed the range of the radar. In last sections, we already discussed the maximum unambiguous range of radar. So today we are going to discuss the radar applications and the frequencies in the different sections. The main objective of this lecture is to learn the radar fundamentals, operating frequencies, and the application. So in this lecture, you will able to understand the concept of the frequency spectrum of radar and the application. What are the different applications and where the radar is applicable in the different fields. So today we have the basic concept of the radar for the surveillance and the tracking. So in this section we also discuss the different type of the radars also. So today we are going to learn the basic operation frequency of radars and the basic applications in the military, civilians, industrial, and the airport or in the airline systems. So these are the different applications. Contents of the today's lecture is the first we will discuss the introduction of the radar, what are the types of the radars, radar frequencies, radar applications. So these are the main content of video lecture. After going through or watching through this video lecture, you will be able to understand the basic frequency mechanism or frequency division of the radars. And you will also be able to understand the application of radar. After these two topics, we will discuss the basic type of the radar. And after that, we have some multiple choice question. These are the textbooks, introduction to the radar systems, Merrill Sconic, Tata McGraw-Hill, Special Indian Edition, Second Edition, Tata McGraw-Hill. Introduction to the Radar Systems, Skolnick, Third Edition, Tata McGraw-Hill. Radar Principles, Technology, Application, John Eddy, Pearson Education, 2004. Principles of the Modern Radar, Basic Principle, by Mark A. Richard Jams and the Sheer William A. Holm, SD 2013. Radar Handbook by M.I. Skolnick, Second Edition, Tata McGraw-Hill. And last reference book is the Understanding the Radar Systems by the Simon Kinsley and John Fink, Scientech Publication, McGraw-Hill. These are the textbook and reference book. If you will go through with these books, that is the textbook by M.I. Skolnick by Tata McGraw-Hill, you will easily understand the basic concept of radar. You will also be able to understand the frequency mechanism and the frequency division or frequency bands in radars by governed by the ITU and IEEE societies. And you will also be able to understand the operation and applications of radar. Outcome of this video lecture is the student will understand the concept of the radar frequencies. They will learn the different frequency of radar, where they applicable and what bands we are able to use by the different governing bodies, that is the ITU and IEEE. They decide the different bands of radars. They also learn the different application of radar. Means a student will be able to understand the concept of radar with their particular frequencies and where we can use a different radar for a different applications. So they will also understand the applications as a with respect to the frequency. Introduction. Again, the radar is a stand for the radio detection and ranging. Means radar is the device or system which is used to detection and ranging. And it is the primarily a detection tool which detects the target and the object. The source of that detection mechanism is the radio waves. So the basic building block or basic backbone of radar is the radio waves. Through radio waves, the radar is able to detect the object or target. Radar is an electromagnetic system for the detection and the location of the objects. It operates by transmitting a particular type of the waveform, a pulse modulated sine wave, for example, and detects the nature of the echo signal. So our radar is a work on the concept of the electromagnetic waves, and it is basically to design a system to detect the object and locate the object. And in this operation of radar system, the transmitting a pulse, particularly that is known as a transmitting pulse by the magnetron source, which is used in the transmitter section. So we are able to understand that the basic concept of radar is to detect and find and locate the our any object, to detect the nature of the echo signal. So our in terms of echo signal, in the next section we have the radar frequencies. What are the different frequencies used by radars? So conventional radars are operated at the frequencies extending from about 220 megahertz to the 35 gigahertz. A spread of more than 7 octaves, these are not necessarily limits, since the radar can be and have been operated at the frequency outside the either end of this range. So this is the lower limit and the upper limit of the radar. In this we are able to understand that the 220 megahertz to 30 megahertz is the a band of radar frequency operation. Beyond this, the radar is also able to work. So outside of this frequency, we are able to apply in the radar system. So 35 megahertz is the upper range, and beyond this we are also able as our application. So next is the place of radar frequencies in the electromagnetic spectrum is shown in the figure. So in the electromagnetic spectrum, we have a particular designation of radar bands. A particular designation is assigned by the ITU and IEEE society. So these radio wave bands is known as radar band or radar frequency bands, and it is specified in a particular band in the electromagnetic spectrum. Some of the nomenclature employed to the designate the various frequency regions is also shown in this figure. So electromagnetic spectrum is shown in the figure, that is the total electromagnetic frequency spectrum, and this is the divided into the scale of the wavelength as well as the frequencies. So frequency and wavelength are inversely proportional to the each other. Before discussing this, we are going to discuss the frequency band. Here in the lower side or the bottom side of this image or the picture, it is shown that the frequency band, that is the starting from the 30 hertz to the 3000 gigahertz. So 30 hertz to the 300 hertz is the one band. 300 hertz to the 3 kilohertz is the another band. Next is the 3 kilohertz to 30 kilohertz. Then we have a 30 kilohertz to 300 kilohertz, 3 megahertz to the 30 megahertz, 30 megahertz to the 300 megahertz, 300 to the 3 gigahertz, 3 gigahertz to the 30 gigahertz, 30 gigahertz to the 300 gigahertz, and 300 gigahertz to the 3000 gigahertz. So this is the frequency scale. And this frequency region is divided into the different region, that is the audio frequency region, then we have a radio frequency region, then we have a video frequency region, microwave region, and radar band or radar region, radar frequency range. So this is the complete frequency spectrum. Now we are coming on that the wavelength. In the term of the wavelength, if we are talking about the wavelength, range is starting from the 10 kilometer, that is the maximum value of the wavelength, and it is going up to the 0.1 centimeter, millimeters. So that is the 10 kilometer to 1 kilometer is the one band, 1 kilometer to 100 meter is the second band, 100 meter to the 10 meter is the next, and 10 meter to the 1 meter is next, 1 meter to the 10 centimeter is another band, and 10 centimeter to the 1 centimeter is another next band, and 1 centimeter to the 1 millimeter, and then we have 0.1 nanometers. So this is the complete wavelength of the electromagnetic spectrum, and we have some frequency nomenclature, that is the VLF. VLF stands for the very low frequency, and the in the terms of we are talking about in the terms of the wavelength. So the myrometric waves is known as VLF, and LF is the low frequency. It is another band is known as in the case of the wavelength. We know that the kilometric waves. So the medium frequency band is the another band, and then we have the name in the terms of the wavelength is the hectrometric waves, and band number 6. Next band is the HF. HF is stand for the high frequency band, and in the case of the wavelength, we also nomenclature that band is the decometric waves, and band number 7. Further, we have the VHF band, that is the very high frequency band, or it is used in the TV receiver systems, and this is known as the metric waves. It is known as the metric waves. And it is also known as the band number 8. Next is the ultra high frequency, that is used in the nowadays in the TV receiver system, and its name in the terms of wavelength is the decimetric waves, and the band number 9 is the name of this band. And next is the SHF, super high frequency. It is known as the centimetric waves, and band number 10. EHF is the extremely high frequency, that is the millimetric waves, and it is known as the band number 11. So millimeter waves is the in the terms of the wavelength. And last is the band number 12, and it is known as the submillimeter waves or decimillimeter metric waves, and our radar frequency band is lies between the VHF to the EHF bands. This is the radar frequency band, and the medium frequency range, also known as the broadcast band, and high frequency band is also known as the OTH radar band. And the letters designation in the radar frequency bands are L, S, C, X, KU, and Ka band. This is known as the microwave region or the microwave window. So this is our complete electromagnetic spectrum through which we are understand the basic frequency bands with their corresponding wavelength. Now, the letter code designation of radar frequencies. In previous spectrum band, we already discussed the S band, K band, Ka band, KU band, X band, L band. That is the letters which is the governed for specifically for radars. In a development of a radar, a letter code such as the X, L, S, X, L, etc. was employed to designate the radar frequencies band. Although its original purpose was to guard the military secrecy, the designations were maintained probably out of the habit as well as the need for some convenient short nomenclature. These are the some short nomenclature in the radar frequency bands or radar designation. Its original purpose was to guard the military secrecy. So these type of the latter is generally used in the secrecy in the case of the military purpose, and they maintain the high security in the radar frequency bands. So letter code designation of radar frequency is the nomenclature of radar frequency band in the case of the military applications. This use has the continued and is now an accepted the practice of the radar engineers. So all the radar engineers will accept these bands. They are habitual or they are familiar with these type of the bands. The table below lists the radar frequency letter band nomenclatures adopted by the IEEE. These are the related to the specific bands assigned by the International Telecommunication Union for radar. So IEEE and ITU, that is the International Telecommunication Union for radar, assigned the specific bands for the applications of radars. If you are going to design a particular radar, then you have to knowledge about the frequency bands of radar. Next, for the example, although the nominal frequency range for L band is the 1000 to the 2000. Means this is the a particular frequency band for the case of our L band, that is the designated by L, alphabetical letter L. A L band radar is though thought of as being confined within the region from the 1215 to the 1400 megahertz, since that is the extent of assigned band. It is the extension of assigned bank. So the particular lower and upper range of the L band is the 1000 to 2000. And in this region, we generally use the 1200 to 1500 to 1400 megahertz, which is the region or the frequency range for L band. From this table, you easily understand that the L band is nominal frequency range is the 1000 to 2000. For the particular application of the radar by governing by the ITU is the 1200 to 1400 megahertz. Similarly, for the high frequency, very high frequency, UHF, ultra high frequency, L band, S band, C band, X band, Ku band, Ka band, K band and millimeter wave range is shown in the table, through which we are able to understand the nominal frequency range and the bands by on the ITU, International Telecommunication Union. So high frequency band consisting the nominal frequency range 3 to 30 megahertz. Similarly, VHF, that is the very high frequency band designation, consisting the nominal frequency range 30 to 300 megahertz. And the radar band is for 30 to 300 megahertz range. That is the particular radar band is given that the 138 to 144 megahertz. So 216 to 225 is the second band in the case of VHF. Next band is the UHF band, ultra high frequency. It is lies between the 300 to the 1000 megahertz in the case of the nominal frequency range. If we are talking about the radar band, so it will comes at 420 to 450 megahertz with 890 to 942 megahertz. And L band stand for the 1000 to the 2000 megahertz, and it stand in the case of the radar bands, that is the 1215 to the 1400 megahertz. S band stand for 2000 to the 4000 megahertz, and in the case of radar bands governed by the ITU, it will become say 2300 megahertz to 2500 megahertz, and 2700 to the 3700. That is the second band in the S band. C band stand in the nominal frequency range, that is the 4000 to the 8000 megahertz. And in the case of the radar band by ITU, that is the 5250 to the 5925 megahertz. Now, band. X band is 8000 to the 12000 megahertz, and the radar band by the ITU is the 8500 to the 10680 megahertz. Ku band, that is the 12.280 gigahertz, and we have a 13.4 to 14 gigahertz Ku band, and 15.7 to 17.7 gigahertz for the Ku band by the ITU systems. K band stands from 18 to 27 megahertz, and in the case of the radar bands, specific radio location radar band by ITU, the K band stands from 24 to 05 to 24.25 gigahertz. Ka band stands from 27 to the 40 gigahertz. So we understand that the millimeter wave range is stand because if you will design